Hi and welcome. Today I will show you how to make Greek yogurt, which is plain yogurt strained so it loses most of its whey. It's very easy. You will need 1 gallon of whole milk, 2 spoons of yogurt, good yogurt, and a kitchen thermometer. You start by boiling the milk until it starts to rise, in which point it's about 185 degrees. And then you pull it off the fire and wait until it cools down. The milk has to cool down to somewhere between 108 and 115 degrees Fahrenheit so it doesn't scorch the starter. While the milk is cooling, I'm gonna pull out about half glass of this boiled milk in which I will dilute my starter. For a starter, I will use 2 spoons of my old yogurt, the leftover yogurt that I have. If you don't have the first batch, then use any good yogurt, as long as it doesn't contain pectin or gelatin, because you're not much likely to have success with those. Make sure that the yogurt you use for a starter contains only milk and cultures and nothing else. I stir the yogurt in the warm milk until it's totally dissolved, and then when the milk in the pot has reached between 108 and 115 degrees, I will pour the glass of milk with the dissolved yogurt in it. I will give it a good stir to make sure that the cultured milk is evenly dispersed in the pot. And then I will cover it with a towel, and then I put the lid on the pot. The reason I put towel under the lid is to absorb any moisture that comes up from condensation so water doesn't drip back in the yogurt. Now I will put the pot in the oven where it will stay undisturbed overnight with the oven light on. The oven light will provide enough heat for the yogurt to ferment. 10 hours later, and the yogurt must be set by now. Let's see. It looks pretty solid, like you see. See, it comes apart at the edges of the pot. But still, this yogurt contains a lot of whey. It's about halfway. That's why it has to be strained. So I have this big bowl, I put a strainer on top, and I have this bag which I made from muslin, and I will put the yogurt in there and onto the strainer. Before I had this bag made, I used to use a pillowcase, a 400 thread count pillowcase that I had bought specially for this purpose, so you can too. Now I have this wooden spoon and I will tie it with a bag like this, and I will use this as a lever, you know, to twist the bag to make sure that there's enough pressure to get the whey out. 3 hours later, I take the yogurt out of the refrigerator. It's about half the amount that it was before. The rest is all whey that has drained out. Some people drink this whey, or they use it in smoothies and stuff, or they cook with it. I think it tastes like piss and I throw it out in the winter. And in the summer I water the plants with that. The plants seem to like it. So I'm gonna fill up my yogurt container again, and you see how thick and creamy this yogurt is, and it's also very sweet and tasty. One gallon of milk yields about 2.5 quarts of good thick Greek yogurt. And it's delicious, not because I made it, it is very good. This is excellent yogurt to eat by itself or mixed with granola and nuts, or mix with your favorite jam or marmalade or grape confit that I have another video for, or you can make tzatziki with it, and soon I will show you a very good recipe for Greek tzatziki. If you want to go fancy, put it in a cornet and put it in a ice cream glass like you see here, and garnish with your favorite syrup and nuts.